feeling headbanging. Lennon, are you ready for a knockout round? You're not? Do you think Pearl Jam can get beat by Stone Temple Pilots?
Hey, what's going on? It's Trey with Imagine Just Records. I got my sidekick, Little Lennon. As in the BC, he started to get the nickname as Little L. So, let me fix that. It's a Saturday morning. We are, it's kind of raining, so there's not a lot for us to do today. So we figured we'd get on here and film a video. So I want to start a new series. It's called Knockout Rounds, where I'm going to show an album. I'll show two albums at a time, and we'll vote on it and see which one you guys like the best. The album that is the best, that gets the most votes, we'll move on to the next round. So as you can hear in the background, one of my favorite bands, kind of don't know if this is a fair contest because this band is just loved by so many, but hey man, you gotta put them up against something. So the album that I'm gonna start with, a lot of us that play music, we've all called the holy grail of rock and roll, and this is Pearl Jam's 10. This is probably one of the best rock albums to date. This is actually a reissue, so as you can see, it's got the cool inserts and the gatefold. You've got Once, you've got Even Flow, you've got, just Black. So many great songs off this record. One of my favorite songs on this record is the opening track, Once. Let's see here. So we've got Once, Even Flow, Alive. Jeremy Black, golly. This album was recorded in 1991. It came out in 1991. It was Pearl Jam's very first record. It sold 13 million copies. It produced so many singles. It got so many people into music. Myself, I tried to learn how to play guitar in every one of these songs. It kind of came out kind of on the leg of Nirvana with Nevermind. They were kind of pushing the hair bands out, which was cool. But, I always said that the hair bands I always thought always played guitar really well. The grunge, they kind of played power chords. It was more about the lyrics, more about the sound, more about the feelings. But this is Pearl Jam 10. Now, what would you think that could, an album that would come out around its time that could give this album a run for its money? So this is going to be the first album in the knockout rounds. It's Pearl Jam 10. All right, and the second album that's going to go against Pearl Jam 10 is going to be Stone Temple Pilots' Core. Now, I know Pearl Jam is a badass album, but so is this. This was Scott Weiland's. This is their very first album. It's also their biggest album to date. It sold 9 million copies. And it's got Dead and Bloated, Sex Type Thing, Wicked Garden, Creep, Plush. The three singles off this record was Sex Type Thing, Creep, and Plush. But this was, so we got Pearl Jam with, we got Pearl Jam 10, which was their very first album. Their very first album. And then we got Stone Temple Pilots with Core. Like I said, Pearl Jam 10 is a badass album, but come on guys, there's gotta be some Scott Weiland love. Even though I've met him in person and he is not a good person at all. Rest in peace, but this guy, he was not a nice guy. My band opened for them and the rest of the band was really cool. But this was not when he was in Stone Temple Pilots. This is when he was touring with the Weiland's like Wildabouts or something like that. But this is going to be Stone Temple Pilots' Core. This is a reissue, so it's got the, on the second side, it's got a little cool, like, I don't know if you can see it, maybe not, oh, there you go. have my Stone Temple Pilots on. Of course, it's on the beautiful Atlantic Records label. Alright guys, so I definitely want to hear, I want to hear from you what you think. I mean, is it going to be moving on to the next round? Is it Pearl Jam 10? Or is it Stone Temple Pilots Chord? Post down at the bottom, vote, and next week we'll see who moves on and who they go up against. You guys take it easy. It's a Saturday morning. It's raining. Can't take Little Lennon to the park, but what you guys think? All right, Lennon. Tell everybody in the BC. See you guys later. Y'all have a good weekend. What do you think about that solo, Lennon?